There is no one who enjoys falling down. It's probably an experience that no one really likes. But I like skydiving, bungee jumping, and base jumping. It makes me really happy, you might say. But believe me, you certainly don't like falling. Not even your body does. You may still argue that you like it because you feel this thrill every time you're falling down. Well, the truth is, the thrill you get when falling is the panic that's been hiding inside you for millions of years. It's as if it's being activated every time you fall, shouting and screaming, trying to remind you that all your ancestors died going down what they think is fun. But even if that's the case, have you ever wondered what the maximum distance you can jump off from anywhere in the world is? Well, in this video, we're going to talk just about that. But first, keep in mind this very important rule. In the duration of your fall, you must be falling continuously and vertically. This simply means you can't jump off of something, tumble at something else below it, bounce off, and then fall again. Your fall has to be clean and uninterrupted. Let's begin looking for the place where you can do the longest and cleanest vertical jump. Let's consider the places where falling is even possible. First is the Burj Khalifa in Dubai, which is 828 meters tall. This structure is theoretically the tallest man-made structure that you could use to jump off and fall. It would take about 20 seconds of continuous freefall from its top to the bottom. You might think this isn't the highest height from which you can jump, since there's Mount Everest. You may believe that the best place to jump off of is Mount Everest. But with vertical and continuous falling, it isn't the best option. Let me explain to you why. Remember the important rule we discussed earlier? Your fall must be completely vertical and uninterrupted. That very reason eliminates Mount Everest from the choices. Why? First and foremost, I must admit that Mount Everest has some really steep cliffs. However, take a look at its overall structure. It is somehow made up of a chaotic rock formation. I mean, there tends to be chunks of rocks right below one another. That means if you jump from the top, you'll possibly just strike another chunk of rock, bounce off of it, and then fall down the mountain slide, bouncing and rolling all the while. It isn't a vertical or continuous fall, which is also not the goal of this episode. There are cliffs all around the world in which you can fall higher than that of Mount Everest, vertically and continuously. One of these cliffs is an extremely deep hole in China's Tianxin Cave. Inside the cave, there is a shaft that measures 1,026 meters from top to bottom. That's way deeper than the Burj Khalifa's height. In theory, when you jump off this hole, it would take about 24 seconds of falling uninterruptedly before striking the bottom in absolute darkness. But other natural features of this hole should be considered before choosing this place. The next to consider if you're looking for a place in which you can drop vertically and in the absolute highest range is Baffin Island, located in Canada's Nunavut province. This place is one of the world's least populated areas, yet if you explore the place, you'll be able to see Mount Thor, the world's tallest confirmed cliff. The cliff is tilted at a 105 degree angle, making it much steeper than vertical. It wasn't until 1985 that humans were able to successfully climb its peak. When you manage to get to its top and jump off, you'll experience a vertical and uninterrupted fall from 1,250 meters above, and it takes around 28 seconds before you hit the ground. However, this was only considered as the world's tallest confirmed vertical cliff due to its distant location. There are other cliffs that could be just around it that might theoretically be much taller, and since no one has found them yet, we have no idea about those cliffs right now. But in Pakistan's far northern corner lies a series of mountains known as the Trango Towers. The discovery of the Trango Towers, which also has the other confirmed cliff with a higher vertical drop, poses a question to Mount Thor's claim to be the world's steepest vertical cliff. Great Trango is the tallest mountain in the Trango Towers. This mountain is widely regarded as the hardest to climb in the world. Additionally, it has an almost vertical cliff that drops 1,340 meters from the top. Because the cliff isn't quite as vertical as the one on Mount Thor, people in the world of geography keep having debates and arguments over its title and standing. But let's not dive into that. Let's leave that to the experts to figure out. You are watching this video because you just want to know about the highest fall you can do. Moving on, if you could get to the top of the Great Trango and jump from there, your vertical fall would take about 30 seconds, which is 2 seconds longer than jumping from Mount Thor's summit. We've now identified the highest possible places and points on the planet from which you can jump and fall vertically and continuously. But what if you were to jump off the cliff outside the Earth? I believe there are cliffs everywhere in the universe. Thus, there must be one even higher than the ones here on Earth. For example, if you could travel to Uranus and then to its moon Miranda, you could find a 20-kilometer high cliff on it, and that's a vertical cliff base. The cliff is more than twice the height of Mount Everest on Earth, yet you can jump off of it and survive, since the gravity on Miranda is much lower than on Earth. The duration of the fall would be around 12 minutes before hitting the bottom. It's worth noting, though, that you could only be falling at a speed of around 124 miles per hour. Yes, that still sounds really scary, but considering the conditions, you could probably make it work if you had some airbags with you. And I know what you're thinking about jumping out of planes, which surely counts as a vertical and continuous fall. If you're that curious, then let's talk about it. Vesna Vulovic, a woman who holds the record for being the person to survive falling out of an airplane at the tallest height without using a parachute in the world. To make her story short, after the plane blew up, she managed to survive a fall from nearly 10,000 meters in the sky. And the remarkable aspect is that she did it without using a parachute. She reportedly fell for 3 minutes and 25 seconds, but that's not yet the highest vertical fall ever. In the year 2012, Felix Baumgartner and the Red Bull Stratos team set the world record for the highest free fall in the world. Baumgartner managed to fly to a frightening height of 39 kilometers above the Earth's surface in a capsule connected to a balloon. He then simply jumped out of that height wearing only a pressure suit and having a parachute for landing. His fall lasted around 4 minutes and 19 seconds. His body reached a speed of 843.6 miles per hour. As a result, he was dubbed the first human being to break the sound barrier without the use of an engine. Even so, the Red Bull team believed that if Baumgartner hadn't used his parachute a little too early, his fall could have lasted somewhere between 5 to 6 minutes. Baumgartner's freefall record was broken 2 years later by a man named Alan Eustace. Eustace, unlike Baumgartner, did not travel up a fancy capsule. Instead, he attached himself to a balloon and went up to 41.4 kilometers above the ground. When he finally reached the point, he used a device to detach himself from the balloon and begin his fall. Before releasing his parachute, Eustace fell about 37,616 meters high, which is around 4 minutes and 27 seconds. That record made him the person who has jumped off from the farthest point and fallen the longest in human history. To this day, no one has ever beaten his record. But what humans can achieve is undoubtedly more than that. In fact, the Red Bull Stratos team predicted that they could do a 6-minute vertical fall. Furthermore, Baumgartner and Eustace's achievements have shown that human beings can fall from the stratosphere, as well as possess the ability to reach speeds that can break the sound barrier. Whatever the maximum distance humans can go, it is yet to be discovered. I'm sure that there will be someone in the future that will shock and, at the same time, fascinate the public for making a new freefall record. It's even possible that someone we're waiting for is the one watching this video right now. If you're really into skydiving, base jumping, or bungee jumping, or if you're interested in breaking the freefall record one day, or you're just into anything that thrills you and excites you, you'll need to understand everyday physics, your strengths, and the farthest point you're going to fall from. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more videos like this. And as always, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.